North Carolina Congressman Robert Pittenger is with the U.S. delegation in Germany to meet with the released prisoners. He joins us now by phone. Congressman, can you tell us what's happening with the freed Americans right now?
Yes, sir. They are with the physicians, the psychologist, and all those who are attending to them. We're in a remarkable facility, and they are getting great attention that's important for them at this time. This is a very critical phase for them as they've come out of a very oppressive environment where they were, for the most part, left in isolation, had a lot of mental torture, and this will take time to process out and help them. Pastor Saeed was there for 3.5 years, so we hope and pray for his emotions and mental abilities to be sustained and be fully recovered.
Can you describe a little bit more their condition? What can you tell us about their condition?
Their physical condition is okay, and there is no communicable diseases. So I think that part is good.
At what point will you be able to meet with them?
Well, I'm going to defer to Nagabe. I do not plan to go in before she does. I wouldn't want to do that. But that, frankly, is in the protocol of the doctors. And they want to make sure that these gentlemen are ready to receive their families. This is a very much an emotional trauma that they've gone through.
Can you talk a little bit about the role that Franklin Graham is playing?
Well, Franklin has been a good friend of Ms. Abedini through this period. I was encouraged to get involved because of Franklin and also because of Dr. David Chadwick in Charlotte, the pastor of the Forest Hill Church. So my interest is there because they've asked me to be involved.
Can you give us a preview of what you will say to them once you do meet them?
Well, God bless you. We're just grateful to God that you're here. And certainly I have concerns over the conditions by which they were left there. I think, frankly, we could have negotiated them out when we committed $700 million a month to Iran as a precondition to coming to negotiations 2 years ago. We gave them $12 billion just to get them to the table. That would have been a good time to ask them for the release.
Can you tell us a little bit more about the process of getting them out from the country back home? How long is that going to take?
Typically, for those who have been hostages, when they come here to go begin the process of re-assimilation, they're usually here 5 to 10 days, and then they will go home for the next phase of their treatments.
How would you encourage Americans to pray for Pastor Saeed Abedini as well as the other two hostages?
Well, they've been in a very demonic atmosphere, and it's been very oppressive. And when you're left in isolation, when people come in and scream and yell at you and physically, emotionally abuse you, tell you when you can sit down, when you can eat, when you can go to the bathroom, they haven't made a decision in years on their own. The transition in their life is going to be extraordinary. So just being able to communicate, be back with their families is going to be a real challenge. This is going to be a very hard process.
And talk to that point, the sort of the challenges between husbands and wives, and the strain that it puts, I'm sure, on moms and dads, and just the whole process that, for example, Nagme is probably going to experience.
Well, I think marriages have their own challenges. There's no perfect marriages I'm aware of, except with the Lord, but they will go through a real transition, and that's why this time for Saeed to be with these psychiatrists to help him understand why he's doing and thinking the way he is, and she needs to be understanding that too. It's not going to be just a normal situation going back together, and I think we just really need to pray that God would heal and totally their hearts, and his heart particularly, and allow him to be free of all the bitterness and hatred and the defensive mechanisms that you naturally build up to protect yourself.
Congressman Pittenger, thank you so much for joining us. I appreciate your insights.
God bless you.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.